Well, the last 2 months has been filled with a lot of stuff like this. We've been trying to reorganize our home, moving things around, trying to make it a little bit more easy for us to live in. And I built this shelf myself. It's not great, but it's functional and will work well for us. Still got to do these two shelves, stain them. But it's too cold out there right now for the stain to cure well. But now moving into my gardening stuff. We're still kind of in a planning stages for a lot of things right now. We decided to go ahead and start our onions. We've been starting them, you know, like March, April. But we haven't really been getting very good onions on this, so we are now starting our onions earlier, and we'll see what happens with that. This is going to be our little seed starting station, and starting in the next 2 weeks, we're going to be starting all of our herbs and stuff. The problem that we have been having is when we start our herbs from seed, at the times they suggest, they're not doing well. The only things that have done well have been the ones that we bought from the stores and they were already established. So we're going to trying to establish our herbs early so that when we put them out, we'll have some well-established seedlings already. And the intention is to start them here and then move them upstairs into our attic. It will be a little bit cooler, but if we've already got established plants, they should do just fine up there until it's warm enough to be able to put them outside. Here is my ginger. Now, I showed these things a few months ago when I brought them in, and if you saw that and you remember it, all of the ginger plants actually died, so we left them in to see what would happen, and four of them did come back out of seven. I've got three that are doing real well, and I've got another one here that I could use some advice on. You see how the leaves are doing. This is the only one that's doing this. And it is one the one that started putting up shoots earlier than the others. Now, I've been doing some research, and two things that popped up that it could have been. One is called soft rot, but the symptoms are only on the leaves, it's not into the stalk, and the other is bacterial wilt, but this really doesn't look like bacterial wilt. So anybody got any kind of suggestions on this, you know, wondering if I should just toss it or not? The one thing is that this has stopped. It's not getting any worse. We'll see what happens with this leaf here. This one developed a little bit around the edges. But if anybody's got any idea what has happened with this, I'd appreciate a little bit of help on that. Now, one more little bit of information about this is that a few weeks ago, I did overwater this, so it could be due to that. Now, there's two new things here that is kind of new to me. I thought I'd show you guys. I guess we'll start with this one first. This is a deer hide. My father-in-law is, or was, a hunter here. He can't really do too much hunting, but friends of his bring deer by and he cuts them up for them. And I asked him a couple of months ago about his hunter friends, you know, what they do with the hides, and they just throw them away. So I asked him if he could see about getting the hides for me and let me try my hand at tanning hides. They brought this one in a couple of days ago, and it kind of surprised me. I was not prepared for it. I kind of expected them to give me a heads up that they might still be coming in. But right now, I've got it fleshed, and I got salt all on the inside trying to cure the hide there. And I am going to do this hair off, let this salt sit in there for a day or so, try to kill all the bacteria, salt the hide good, and then I'll soak it and get all this, and I'm going to try to start making buckskin. See, the thought just occurred to me that, you know, if these hunters are out there killing deer, you know, it's just a waste to let those hides go by. You know, I've tried to go buy buckskin and other leather around here to do some things, but it is so expensive to buy this stuff that I decided I wanted to try my hand at it. Besides, I have this very serious problem with going and killing an animal and letting parts of it go to waste. That's just not the way that I was taught when I was younger, and I'm very glad I was taught that way. I learned a lot of respect for the animal world. Next thing is a rocket stove. I know Southpaw Davey may be interested in this. He said he wanted to see a video of it when I got it going. But I finally got this going, and it does burn okay. But the first time I tried it, it didn't do well. And I put this on top to see if it would get a better draw, and it did help. The next thing is that this, I believe, is just too small. For one thing, the feed tube for the fuel, it doesn't hold enough fuel. And I'm also thinking that it's just not getting enough air. So I am going to, probably in the next week or so, redo this and use one of these about the same size and give that a try. I've also got another one of these right here, and what I'm thinking of doing is soldering it onto the top so that it'll raise up to about this high, and I'll have even a taller fire tube. But another question about this, maybe someone can help me with. I have been wondering about proper ratios for air intake and for the draw tube. Does anyone out there experienced with rocket stove have an idea what the best ratios are for these two tubes for their sizes? Most of the videos that I've seen and the articles that I've seen, most people are just trying different things out until they get something that would work. I am thinking that, you know, if we can find some kind of a standard just to start out with, you know, of the different ratios, that it might help other people who are just starting out with it. Well, the weather has been such that, you know, I really couldn't get out and do a whole lot of work up at our other property. Either raining or snowing, and since I've got to work on a steep slope, I just felt that it was a little bit too dangerous to be getting out there with chainsaws and other stuff that I need to work with, especially considering that, you know, I've got certain injuries that I have got to be careful of. But I am hoping that within the next few weeks I can get back out and get started on this. I've already got plans for right here to build a large tomato house. We lost all of our tomatoes last year, primarily due to the fact that we didn't have a tomato house, and we lost everything to blight. So we're going to try a tomato house right here, and I'm also going to try to design it so that in wintertime it can be a greenhouse as well. Well, that's it for today. Y'all have a good day.